Necromunda is hell. A hive world forever on the brink. In their glittering spires, the lords and ladies wage wars of words. Deep below, the underhive runs with blood as gangs brawl over stinking crawlways. But darker threats than gangs fester in the starless depths. Eyes that have never seen the sky now turn hungrily on each other. We are all that stands between order and madness. The last word of Lord Helmar. The dark uprising has begun. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Necromunda.
Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. So Spiel has officially shown off its previews. If you're not aware, Spiel is going on in Germany at the moment. There's two big previews coming within a week of each other. This was the first one, Spiel. This was mainly aimed for board games. And as you can see, Necromunda is a part of that. There's a lot of Age of Sigmar, Blood Bowl stuff being announced as well. Warcry and all that kind of stuff, because it's mainly for the board games when it comes to GW and stuff like that. But next week, I think it's less than a week now. I think it's just over a week. I think it's 8 days away. Blood and Glory is about to hit, and that is where we got to get like the first big Warhammer studio preview on the upcoming things. And I'm sure that Psychic Awakening is going to be a massive part of that. I'm sure that the Sister stuff will be a massive part of it, since Sisters are launching in November. I'm sure they'll tease it even more, and hopefully maybe a little bit more things that are probably coming maybe after Christmas and all that kind of awesome stuff. But back to the subject on hand, which is of course Spiel and this new box set called Dark Uprising. It says Dark Uprising is a fresh take on Necromunda for both veterans and newcomers. There's a new, well, it says two complete gangs, the Twisted Cork Grinders, which I really think look pretty awesome. The first thing I thought when I saw these is that these could make some really cool Chaos Cultists, or, you know, like kind of like Khorne Berserker upgrade kits and stuff like that. But that's where my mind went to straight away, because, you know, we definitely need some new Khorne stuff when it comes to those guys. And of course the Palanite Enforcers, which are basically the 40k police, or, well, like the kind of elite guard for the police, I've been told. They've got like a new shield option, which I think is incredible, because I'm thinking, could I get these shields and nick them and maybe stick it on my Primaris and make like a full-on Primaris Breacher squad? Just for the rule of cool, that's all. Just for the rule of cool. But if you play Necromunda and, you know, and you like these gangs anyway, or you've been waiting for this this new Grinder Cult gang, I think you're going to be pleased. I think they've got really, 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 really nice models. It's probably some of the best gang models I've seen. I can't remember the name of them now, but the ones who like look like Bretonians, you know, like the kind of like peasant ones, I thought they were really cool. But these ones are really nice as well. Now, apart from the models, which I think are incredible, I think they're cool, I like them. The biggest thing for me in this wasn't actually the models itself; it was the terrain, and it's Zone Mortalis terrain, because it mentions in here, including Modular Zone Mortalis terrain. Now, if you've been following the whole rumor hype, the rumor is that Zone Mortalis is getting discontinued on Forge World, which we know from, and it's going into plastic format by GW. And this seems to be the confirmation of that right now, because I haven't seen like the stairs and stuff. I haven't seen that before when it comes to Zone Mortalis. I think it's really, really, really nice. I know a lot of people are fans of Zone Mortalis. I'm a massive fan of Zone Mortalis. Zone Mortalis is an awesome game. Now, if you've never played it before, you'll have to experience it for yourself, because it's even though you can play 8th edition on it, it's not like 8th edition at all. 8th edition for me is a very, very shooty game. Well, when you bring Zone Mortalis into it, it really stops that. It changes it into a kind of, yeah, it's still shooter, but you know, you don't have like the 72-inch range on your, you know, your executioner tank gun or anything like that. You don't get anything like that. It's very melee themed and very close quarters, and that's something I really, really love, especially as a Pyro Fist, because, you know, we like to charge and decimate our enemies in void combat and stuff. So if I can make some funky kind of ship layouts and stuff like that, then I'm very, very excited for this. I'm fingers crossed we'll get even more information at Blood and Glory about this, and maybe we'll see some more previews of the Plastic Zone Mortalis. But yeah, I'm very, very excited to see where they go with this and to see what they do. Again, from just seeing this image now that's in the background, I think it's amazing. I think it's cool. It's well painted. It looks awesome. It definitely fits the Necromunda vibe. and stuff like that. But yeah, I can't wait to see more of it and to see what they actually do. Before we finish the video, I actually forgot about these things right at the bottom. New chibi figures. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that right. Not chubby, not... That's a different saying where I am. So these new chibi figures are coming from GW. As you can see, we've got an assassin, we've got an admet guy, we've got a Primaris Marine, Sisters of Battle, and a Grey Knight. Hopefully Grey Knights get some rules in the future because they are god-awful at the moment. And I love my boys in grey. They're just worthless on the tabletop at the moment. But there we go, some new chibi figures. Am I going to get some? Probably not. Did it look kind of funky? Yeah. Is it for me? No, but again, you may collect these chibis, or chubby figures as I like to call them, a bit of a chubby one for you, and yeah, you know, there's something else for you to buy if you're into all that kind of stuff. That's really it from the event. Of course, there's Age of Sigmar stuff, like there's Warhammer Underworlds if you're into that. There's some Warcry stuff, there's some Blood Bowl stuff, but I don't really cover that because I'm not really into it, and you know, there's really no point in me talking about something that I'm not into. So, right, that is me done for another video. Thank you for going, thank you for watching. Leave your thoughts, feedbacks below in the comment section, and we can have a nice little talk down there. Is anyone else hyped for Plastic Necromunda? Oh, baby, yes, I am. Definitely. Right, see you now, have a good day, and bye-bye.